Well, it looks like we're just starting right off the bat with a combat mission. Let's get going. Raid the Advent convoy. And we get all six people. So, oh, God. I forgot how many of my guys are injured. Or busy. Well, we got a couple of specialists we can bring in. Okay, so I've got two snipers, a heavy, two support, and a rookie. Well, this is gonna go great. Let's make things available, make armor available. Let's put the rookie in armor. And let's see how this goes. You're way farther ahead on this than YouTube's. Yes. Like I said, gotta prep all that content. And if I can't, obviously problems. Okay, so does somebody else have the nano vest? Ah, you do. Yeah, you don't need it that much. We'll give you the battle scanner. We'll give you the med kit and probably the frag grenade. Okay. We'll give her the nanoscale vest. Let's see, what's her name again? I actually don't remember. Shoot. Actually, come to think of it, let's go back. Instead of giving you the med kit, actually I don't have really a choice here. How many supplies do I even have? I can't do anything. We can build like a smoke grenade if I really want to. I don't really need to do so. Holy shit, $85 pre-purchase and season pass for Dark Souls 3. Yeah, that sounds about normal. I need to get more, like, items here. I need more med kits, honestly. Alright, well, this looks like that's going to be the extent of what I can do. Good luck me. Oh, right. We got one more thing I can do. Let's put Rubix. Now, presumably... in that... He does have medical protocol. Okay, good. I'm glad I gave him the medkit then. Of course, he doesn't have the extra uses, but fine. Well, I guess that gets him two uses total. So that's better than nothing. So she'll get the extra HP. Okay, good luck. Remember, you can modify weapons. Yes, though I only use those for characters that actually look like they're gonna have some longevity. I'm not gonna just use them for all of them.
Yeah. Sky Ranger deployed.
In position to drop.
Yeah, people are talking about pre-ordering Dark Souls 3. I don't have a choice. If I'm going to do a YouTube series on it, I gotta buy it full price. Because they don't exactly hand that stuff out to YouTubers. Unfortunately. I'd love for them to do so, but... no can do. Makes me sad. Though I might wait on buying the season pass. I'll have to take a look at that to see if there's actually, like, a day one deal for that.
Assistance tipped us to an Advent transport they managed to disable when it passed through as part of a larger convoy. Advent security forces are already moving to gather their assets, but we've got a shot at finding something valuable here. We'll have to secure the area, recover the gear, and eliminate any enemy resistance.
If you upgrade a weapon and the soldier carrying it dies, do you lose the upgrade? Oh yeah! Not only that, but you can't take upgrades off of weapons, unlike in the previous game. So in this case, if you got a scope and a gun and the character dies, that's it. Or if you replace the scope, that's it. It's gone. You're never seeing it again.
Menace 1-5, the disabled Advent convoy is just ahead. Engage and eliminate all hostile forces.
Okay, so we don't have a time limit here. I've noticed that's been a little bit more regular. I wonder if they patched it or if it's one of my mods. I'm not sure. Okay, so where's the convoy exactly? The problem is they don't really have, like, a beacon here, so I don't really know. Okay, this is the edge, so they're gonna be up ahead. Oh. You know what? It would be that thing. Okay, so in that case, I'm gonna operate under the assumption most of the enemies are gonna be around near the busted up looking SUV van thing. At least that seems like a reasonable response here. Okay. Yeah, considering how they changed the weapon system, it actually makes sense. Yeah, honestly, I like it. I like the new systems in this one. I was mentioning this earlier, but I really would like to play... the original XCOM, Enemy Within, Enemy Unknown, using XCOM 2 systems. Because that actually would be really fun. Just because I do feel like the storytelling in XCOM 2 is a little bit weaker. I guess the progression feels a little bit more procedurally generated in a lot of ways. Okay, so we still don't know where they are. Problem is, we don't have any good high cover here either. Okay. Seeing as we don't have a time limit, come on. Where's that Olympic throw? There we go. What the fuck is that? It's like a jet-powered dude. Huh. Okay. I found a rocket-powered man. I think I found a floater. What the shit is a floater? And how do I piss it off without getting murdernated? Because it looks like the kind of thing that is going to be able to done murdernate me. Tits. Looks like they can see me from that angle? Weird. Okay. Deadshot's good. You're good. You're good. Let's move you behind this tree. Okay.
Roger, I've got my eyes on.
Scanning.
Scanning.
I'm gonna move him over. Chances are he's gonna be in trouble if he stays there. Okay. I don't know what their plan is. Okay. So they're not there anymore. Which begs questions. I heard something over here. Apparently I'll get spotted if I'm in this house. Or there. Okay, who's the guy with the battle scanner? Do we got any more Olympic throws on this? There we go. Okay, so they're just kind of broing out behind. Let's see. But how do you piss them off without getting in deep shit? I guess I could move right there. Okay, so here's what we're gonna do.
The aliens may have cleaned up the design, but these monsters are no better than the ones my father dealt with.
Alright, when in doubt, kaboom. Wait.
Eyes on the prize.
Why can he... Oh, because he chucked the thing. Okay, Rubik's. That's a chuck.
Scanning.
You want to do that? Are you the only one left? No, you are. Okay, where can you move to? I'm going to move this guy a little bit closer, too. I believe that's just shrapnel sponge. Okay. There we go. So they're just floaters. I thought there was something special, like some kind of souped-up Avatar Project dealio. Doesn't look like it. When in doubt, kaboom! Okay. So that did some damage. Hopefully they come a-running my direction. There we go! Damn it. Is he not dead yet? Jesus Christ. That thing is tough. And now dead. Awesome. Oh, and apparently we did not actually tell Kickass to do something. Alright, so we've got a heavy lancer. I hate heavy lancers. I'm just gonna suppress him. Problem solved.
Stay put!
Okay, so we've still got this guy. I don't know why we're stuck in targeting mode. Like, this is really weird. I guess worst comes to worst, we just see enemies as scan lines for the next while. Damn it.
Can't take much more of it!
Ow! Christ, dude, calm down. Apparently it's called an Archon. Well, I mean, they said it was about the same thing, so I'm just gonna take it at face value. Alright. He got a crit with his laser sword, though.
Ow!
Okay, 4. Gremlin heal. Let's heal up kick-ass here.
Go medical!
I do like how they improved all the designs from the previous XCOM, as though the aliens actually improved. It feels good. Okay, so we got that taken care of. Glad I got the... I'm glad I have a functional medic now. Now let's see if we can kill this guy. There we go. Okay. So we don't have to deal with the floater. We've got a ton of enemies probably still around, though. Which I'm less than thrilled about. Alright. I'll make it work.
Designated coordinates. Affirmative, covering now.
Okay.
Overwatch.
I'll just go from here. Overwatch. Chances are most of the enemies I'm going to be running into are over in this direction. Because, yeah, we're not going to run into anybody over here, I doubt. Ooh, if I really wanted to go into, like, Nutso, I could actually go, like, really high. And go with, like, kind of a ridiculous, like, hide in that forest dealio. Because I've almost never run into... I almost never run into enemies up in that forest spot. But that would be really silly. And take a lot of time. Luckily, this is not a time-sensitive mission, but still. Okay.
On my way!
Oh, this convoy is more than one truck.
I'm on it!
Well, that would explain some things.
Okay.
Okay. Some of the research you do when reading through it suggests the XCOM had never done some of the stuff. Yeah, they were talking about... Oh, shoot. What were we doing? Like, Illyrium. It didn't make a whole lot of sense that, like, we had to research Illyrium again. It more so sounds like, they lost all of the research in losing the battle or something like that. Like, I actually kind of wish there was a mission where you could go and, like, reclaim the old base. Wherever it is. Kind of hard to have a convoy of one truck. You're not wrong. Okay, I'm actually kind of floored that I haven't run into another enemy yet. We don't have any more battle scanners. Like, we've got this whole area over here, which is a little disconcerting. I'm mostly just hiding behind trees. Let's just keep moving up until we spot somebody. There we go. We have spotted somebody. That's a lot of mutons. Next to a car that looks very explodable. Let's see, which one of you has the... Which one of you can bring the boom? You can bring the boom. How much boom can you bring here? The answer is an approximately decent amount. So if I can hit the car and the mutons here. Let's back that ass up a little bit. There we go.
Bring the pine!
Sounded like bring the pine, honestly. There we go. That's what I'm talking about. Kaboom! Alright. So now that we've kind of futzed up their cover pretty bad. Let's see what else I can do here. Probably don't want to do that with a medic yet. Let's see, Anita name can't go anywhere. Or can't shoot anything yet. Let's get in here. Okay. So we've got him, or... Boom. Nope, not enough range for boom. Oh, shit, did I kill one? I did kill one. Apparently car going boom solves problems. Yeah. I could try and overwatch some people here. Oh, come to think of it, we've got you. Looks like they're in the kill zone. I figured I'd leave them in there. So I could try deadshotting, but that's not going to be good. We could long watch. Let's give it a go. 60% chance. One damage. Nuts. Those are some pretty tall odds, honestly. I'm just gonna back him up.
Absolutely.
Okay. Overwatch. Okay, so we've got a pretty good shot here. I get the feeling the mutons are gonna come forward. And or shoot, actually. Come to think of it, either or will trigger a killing shot here. Alternatively, they just break. or we miss.
That was close.
Okay, no cover. Come on. Kill zone. I don't know why this game is so breaky sometimes with this. Like, it's supposed to be a slow-mo kill cam of her shooting him. Doesn't really work that way. Mostly is just kind of weird and kind of broken. Whatever. Okay, so we still got one Muton left, and potentially a whole second crew hanging out back there. The fuck was that? Shit just went boom. I don't know what shit went boom, but shit just went boom. Alright, so I don't think I have anybody that has suppression. Anita Name doesn't, Derpy Macross doesn't, Shrapnel Sponge definitely doesn't. You have holo targeting, right? You do. Well then, Mr. Holo, Miss Holo Targeting, looks like you have a job here. Shoot at him. Okay.
Out of ammo here.
Graphical glitch is hilarious and doesn't really harm anything. You're not wrong about that, honestly. There we go. Problem solved. Okay. So when do chrysalids come barreling down on you? I'm actually not sure if chrysalids are even in this game. Honestly.
Moving.
Okay.
Scanning.
Doesn't look like we've got anybody. Let's scoot forward a little and reload.
Finally.
I'd like to do more things, but still. Yeah, this was made by Firaxis Games, the people, I believe, that made Civilization, though it might be another sub-studio within their organization. And, Civilization, and did they make anything else? I don't know, actually.
Overwatch.
Okay. You know what? Let's not even... Not even wait. Anybody else can move? No. Okay. I'm just gonna take him the long way around. Get over behind this tree. Might as well just pursue full cover. So what do we have up ahead? I'm trying to be, like, really cautious here, because I don't like losing people. At all.
On my way!
Makes me...
Moving to Overwatch!
Grumpy.
Affirmative. Covering now.
Oh, shoot. Well, when in doubt.
10-4.
We've spotted somebody. We've spotted multiple somebodies. I'm probably gonna regret this. Oh, but we did get an Illyrian core. Okay. Well, I need a name. This might turn out poorly for me. Now, is this guy getting overwatched? There are chrysalids, you just searched it. Alright. Oh, well, he did get shot. How much does he get shot, though? And how much do we just... Okay, he's dead. Oh, fuck me. You know, I'm gonna put together a list of things that I really didn't want to deal with in the next short while. This ranks hellaciously high up there. Shoot. And the one person that could have defended, given her a defensive boost. Okay, well, let's see. So we've got him. He can't see dick all, though, which sucks.
It is clear.
Okay, so we've got a good shot at that advance officer. We might as well. Okay.
Running dry on ammo.
Now we get a sniper. We can take out the advanced officer the rest of the way. We can try and shoot out the advent mech. Can't do... Well, I could do pistol overwatch. Actually, let's do serial. Let's try and kill the advanced officer. Alright, there's one down. Now, that didn't take an action. I can try and dead-eye the mech. Let's give it a go. Bit of a long shot, but I'm banking on it here. Alright. I'm more than a little surprised this is working. She's not gonna kill it. But boy did that count. Okay, so all we've got left is you. Now, we can't do much with this. Yet. Six. No, can't do much there. Alright, let's just repair and hopefully she survives.
Ready to go.
Oh. Right. You're the one with that. Okay, we'll just do Overwatch. Yeah, so hopefully Anita name doesn't just get totally gunned down here. But I get the feeling this is gonna we get an Overwatch. Must save Anita. I mean, RNGesus was waving his halo in our direction right there. That was some good shit. Oh, this is some good shit. So all we got left is one guy. Who's just gonna run off like a dingus. Still gonna shoot her. Ow. But RNGesus really... Oh, crap, she's panicking. Well, that gives her defense. Okay, so that actually works out in my favor. So let's do 4, Gremlin heal. I need a name. Wow.
Give him a heal.
That was some lucky shit. I am happy. So let's heal her back up. We don't have a ranger to just, like, destroy the dude. Oh well, that's fine. But yeah, she's alive. She'll be freaked out, but I can make it work. Let's see, the problem is getting a good shot at the other guy. Okay, so this car's not going to explode again. I can't destroy the, the stuff, unfortunately. Let's see, can I chuck a grenade? Yes. And it's not going to destroy anything, but it will mess up his cover. There we go. Only 3 damage. Shit's on fire. Okay, you're probably not going to be able to shoot anybody from here, but that's expected. Well, that's okay. So you could go for a defensive boost. You can't go anywhere or do much.
Oh yeah.
I'm just gonna move her behind appropriate cover. I don't think we have anything else to deal with here. It's just these guys. Okay. Come to think of it, we've got Kick-Ass. Kick-Ass is a number of shots. Hopefully we can just shoot straight through the car. There we go. Let's just do suppression. I don't know what his plan is, but let's hamper that down a little bit. And we might as well just move closer. I don't think we have to worry about too much, because he's going to get an aim penalty no matter what he does. Ooh, damage! Okay, we're still good. Yeah, we got this. Alright. So panic removed. We got some shots. Let's see, who's the newbie that needs it? Not Rubix. Anita name could use the experience. Alternatively, Shrapnel Sponge, you get the honors. Wait. Oh god, is he that stupid? He is that stupid. Okay, I'm gonna quick save before this happens, just in case things get all broken and dumb. So, I assume Shrapnel Sponge has already gotten a kill. But I don't know, that's not the kind of thing I'm gonna be able to bet on normally. Dingus is hiding right behind an explosive barrel.
Negative! Weapons dry!
Status confirmed. All hostiles are down and the area is secure. Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
Alright, so we took some hits. But that surprises nobody. That actually worked out very well. Nobody died. Yeah, I thought I was in trouble when we started the mission, because I could only bring, like, kind of the rookie-level people, or, like, pretty close, too. And I was worried. But, turns out, no, we got this. We're good.
Yeah!
Dingus was hiding behind an explosive barrel. I don't know, that always amuses me. When it's like, oh wait, no, here's the convenience thing. This also amuses me to no end, the double goggle man. Double goggles, so good. She looks badass. I don't know, I really do like the customization options available in this one. Wish the helmets were a little bit cooler, though. I would love to see people hire... Oh, God. Can you imagine XCOM crossed with, like, Hideo Kojima plot? Like, that kind of tactical stealth gameplay. Even more, like, pushed even further. But the plot is just absolute nonsense. I would actually really enjoy that. Some people would probably think I'm crazy for cooking up an idea like that, but... Like, the problem is the XCOM games, the plot is super just, like, boring and lame and whatever. On the other hand, like, the gameplay is pretty solid as far as I'm concerned. I would enjoy it. People are gonna disagree with me. But I would enjoy it. To no end. Let's see. Did I learn more of the special controls for your troops, like control to move them along a set path? Nope. Didn't do too much. Okay. Oh, really? Kickass was the one that got gravely wounded. Nope, never mind. Anita Name also got down. Okay, blast padding. Oh, thank you. So that's Deadshot. So he just gets an armor of one, I believe. That's cool. So face off. For every enemy or kill zone. Kill zone is just so much more useful. Okay. Rubik's. Revival protocol. So this would be useful to wake them up from stunned, panic, or unconscious. Haywire protocol is just so much more useful, though. Because it means I can take a robot if I'm in range. Okay. I'd rather have medical protocol for this. Combat protocol, kind of useful, and I was originally considering doing that. Okay, we get another sniper. I guess we're gonna have Bullet Sponge be a pistol guy, just because it doesn't make a whole lot of sense. Otherwise, okay. Either way, you got upgraded. And we get 3 Illyrium cores. Yes, we needed those really badly. An Archon corpse. Beneath its elegant exterior, the Archon is a surprisingly haphazard combination of flesh and metal. Yeah, totally floaters. Wow, that's a lot of supplies. Stunlancer corpse, alien alloys, good stuff. Okay, Archon Autopsy. An aesthetically impressive specimen. The hidden horrors of melding organic tissue with the inner workings of a machine are well disguised here. The unique melee weapon employed by this creature could be of particular interest to our rangers. Okay, and Kickass is shaken. Eh, we'll fix her. Okay, so we've got a couple of days before things get fixed. Let's go to the armory, not the armory. Let's go to engineering, proving ground.
The Avenger has a tendency to dip forward when the power core is under load without the engines engaged. At first I thought maybe it was a stabilizer issue, but now I'm starting to think it's all just part of the alien's grand design. The core itself may not be entirely stable, which would explain why the aliens went through so much trouble to isolate it in the bow.
Okay, somebody's making the joke. Why not make Bungie devise the XCOM plot? Now that'd be dumb. Okay, so Bungie does the character and armor designs. Firaxis does the basic gameplay systems. And, enemy variety. Hideo Kojima writes the entire thing. And... I'm trying to think of who does really nice environments. I don't know. I don't know who would do the best environments along the way. It doesn't matter. Okay, so let's do Proving Ground. So we could do a spider suit, which I kind of want to do. Plasma grenade could be fun. Skulljack, experimental ammo. Grenade armor. So, I wouldn't mind getting these things. Let's mess with some experimental stuff. Okay, Let's start with experimental armor. Let's see what we get from that. Okay, do I have any engineers? Alien debris. No, we'll move somebody to that as soon as we get the free time. Okay. Let's see, I got a ton of supplies. I'll spend it later. Bethesda, straight up. I don't know. I don't think Bethesda does good environment art, though. Honestly, like, Skyrim was kind of pretty, but it was really gray. Right, we were going back for our supply drop. Oh, yeah! Square Enix, whomever does the environments for Square Enix is Avenger, a perfect example. There we go! Yeah, So Square Enix does the environments, Bungie does the character armor weapon design, Firaxis does the, like, overall gameplay, and Hideo Kojima writes the whole thing. That will never happen, but still. Okay. So we've got a lot of things to do. I need to get a... Oh god, I have so many things I need to build. Okay, so let's put somebody on the power relay. Jesus, guess you're gonna be here for the rest of your life. Which may or may not come soon or later. I have no idea. Resistance comms, guerrilla tactic school, power relay, empty. Okay, so we need to build several facilities here. So we got shadow chamber. Useful. Decrypting valuable secrets. Defense matrix. Not really sure if that's actually useful or not. Psylab. We're gonna start on the Psylab. It's gonna take for freaking ever. Okay, there we go. We need Metal Gear units in XCOM. As in actual soldiers. If Hideo Kojima's writing the whole thing, I think you get Metal Gears. And I'd be okay with that. Damn it. Alright, we get another one. View room. Okay, let's start building that shadow chamber. Okay. So we've got... Do I have any unstaffed engineers? I have no idea. Let's see if I have... Yep, we got Anna McKay. So that'll speed things along a little bit. Because, yeah, getting the Psylab and getting the, shadow chamber done will be quite the boon. We still got some supplies coming in shortly. Okay. Let's do supply drop. I need my money. There we go. Got it, finally. So let's ignore that, because I have too many things to do. Let's see, West Africa? No. I'd like to get overgrown checkpoint. Oh, the other one did disappear. Alright, that's fine. We also need to make contact in West Asia. When's my... Supply drop, Avenger 16 days. So let's hit the overgrown checkpoint and then keep going. Let's see. Out of curiosity, have you been recruited to the Wanderer Corps? I believe you have. Have I named any of my weapons yet? For the most part, no. I think I named... Oh. Let's see. Let's just carry on. Okay, view soldier. So it's time to redo the coof. So he needs shredder, suppression... Hollow targeting. Volatile mix. Hail bullets or salvo? Salvo. And... I'm actually gonna go with rupture. That'll be way more useful for just ruining certain things along the way. Okay. For those of you that want to be recruited into the, Wander Corps, I have... a couple of videos where you can sign up there and put your details in as opposed to trying to direct me right now. Okay, so let's go back to overgrown checkpoint. This is going to take a while. We've got a lot of things that we're getting done, though, which is nice. Okay, so view room. Workshop. Engineers can be staffed in workshops, creating unique gremlin drones, which can be sent. Honestly, I think I'm just going to leave it... like this for the time being. We'll probably want to build another resistance comms. But we need more power. So let's boost that up here. Okay, that'll give us enough power. But I think for the time being, we're just gonna... wait. Probably? Yeah, because I'll start working on the comms. Nah, fuck it. We got the money now. Let's do some other things. Let's start working on that resistance comm, I think. Because... I truly do not know if the workshop's actually worthwhile or not. I assume so, but I don't want to mess with that. Yeah, I assume the workshop and the laboratory just speed things along. So let's just go with the resistance comm, because this way we can start working on other things. Okay, so we still have an empty room too. That's fine. We also have some things that we can put upgrade points into. Bleh. Oh, that's fine. I don't think we need more than two comms rooms anyway.
I do not think I could have predicted
this. Plasma rifle.
Though it is intriguing.
The aliens aren't going to be
happy when they
see we've got energy weapons just like theirs now.
Yeah.
This is gonna be fun. Okay, so, on more than one occasion during our initial testing of the alien plasma rifles recovered on the field, we nearly suffered a catastrophic loss of the test unit while conducting simple firing runs. After complete disassembly and analysis, it seems that the weapon operates along a very fine threshold between ideal power levels and total system failure. Even the smallest of microfractures to any number of lightly shielded components within the power distribution system could lead to a devastating collapse of field integrity, leaving little chance for the operator's survival. I can only assume, at this point, the aliens had little concern for the well-being of their own forces when designing the weapon, as I have no doubt they discovered this flaw during their own testing. In any case, I'll make the appropriate modifications to our internal designs to ensure no such weaknesses exist for the safety of our troops. So now we can do plasma rifle, beam pistol, scram gun, and we can also research beam cannon, plasma lance, storm gun. Cool. Scram gun. It's the SMG. Beam pistol. Should be obvious. Plasma rifle. That's the basic one. Okay, so what's the storm gun? Presumably this is the machine gun. I'm going to start with the plasma lance, I think. That seems like the reasonable option.
Priority, Commander. I'll notify you as soon as the report is available.
Let's see. How is this compared to the original XCOM? The original, like UFO defense? Bleh. Okay, if you put an engineer in a workshop, it takes two gremlins and that will act like engineers. Okay, I guess I'll start building one of those once I have the supplies for
I'm
it.
Pleased with the research for now, how much we've made so
money
far,
do I have?
But there's still so much more to learn about the aliens' motivations.
Hello, Commander.
Okay, advanced grenade launcher. This would have been really nice, actually. I might be able to get both? No, I can't. Well, let's just build the plasma rifle to begin with. Because that is way more useful along the way. Oh, storm gun is the shotgun. That makes sense. Okay. Honestly, I prefer this to UFO defense. UFO defense was interesting and had some, like, interesting features that I really wish existed in modern XCOM. But oh well.